Hi, everybody. Welcome. It is Wednesday, December the 6th, and I'm so glad that you have chosen to join us here today. We're going to have a little holiday fun today, so we're going to play a little bit in some holiday colors and holiday fabrics, so with some holiday machine quilting on top of that, so we're going to have a little fun today. And I really appreciate you joining me as always. I will ask that you join our Quilt to Join newsletter. We will send out a reminder for our live streams in our newsletter, but we also send out so many other awesome things in our newsletter as well, including things like any sales that we have going on, but also tutorials and downloadables and all kinds of stuff to how you can connect with all the quilt fairies here at Quilted Joy. There's links to our video tutorials as well as downloadable worksheets and all kinds of things if you're a part of the newsletter. So be sure that you are signed up and look for us in your inbox. We don't ever sell your information to another person, so please don't think that we share it. We value you and are happy that you are sharing your information with us, so we certainly don't share with others. So it is December, and of course, every month we have a new Quilt Fairy grouping of thread that visits us for that month. And so for the month of December, you're going to love this group. This is the Solstice Sprite, who's come to visit us, and she will only be here for the month of December. So if you are interested in this limited edition thread pack, grab it now. You can get it in both the King Cone and you can get it in the 1,000 meter cone as well. And so here are the three colors of the Solstice Sprite. And this is a rich, rich red. This is a ruby red. Here, I'll pull it off there. Can you see that okay, Rachel? Rich red, nice Christmas, gorgeous red. And then this one, this is calico. And calico, it has like a coppery, it gives you that kind of metallic-y, this way. This, yeah. It has like a metallic-y copper look to it. Of course, it's just a glide thread. So it's a polyester, 48 weight, but it's a beautiful, beautiful sheen. And then this one is federal. Look at how rich and lovely that blue is. So this is your Solstice Sprite, and she's only here for the month of December, and then she will fly away. So if you want to grab one of these thread packs, head over to quilttojoy.com and pop it into your cart. And we also are having a pretty significant sale on the Millie long arm machine right now, the APQS Millie long arm machine. So we have two features in that APQS Millie package that would normally be extra. That are included in the package. So there's the automatic fabric advance, normally that'd be $2,000. There is the quilt glide feature, normally that would be $2,000. And you get $5,000 off or free financing. So an amazing deal. If you are talking to Santa about possibly getting a long arm machine for Christmas, give us a call here at Quilted Joy. We'd love to talk to you and get all your questions answered. And if you know anyone who is in the market for a long arm machine, if you'd share our information with them, we do ship coast to coast in Canada too, so just let us know how we can help. Just give us a call or send us an email, and we can get your long arm quilting journey started. We are also, as of today, having a big Christmas sale on our Christmas fabric, our Christmas kits, and our Christmas pre-cuts. It is 30% off all of those things. So I have the coupon code for you to use. Now, it's only good for today and tomorrow, and the coupon code is FESTIVE30. FESTIVE30. F-E-S-T-I-V-E 30. And then you can get 30% off all of our Christmas fabric pre-cuts and Christmas kits. And I brought over some Christmas kits here to show you. So this one is the newest one. This one is in the latest edition of the Fonz & Porter Love of Quilting magazine. And this one is my quilt. It's Midnight Frost. It has everything that you need. It has the fabric. It has the papers for the little star points already printed. And it goes together pretty fast because it's really basically a table runner with big swaths of fabric. And this particular quilt, I built a pillow tuck into it so that star swath will hit right in the middle of the bed once you put it on. And that's a finished quilt size of 90 inches by 108 inches. 30% off today and tomorrow with that coupon code. So that is Midnight Frost. And then I have This one is Dashing Through the Snow. And Dashing Through the Snow uses the Kimberbell Cup of Cheer fabrics. They are adorable. And it's actually the quilt that I have behind me. So the quilt that I have behind me is not in Christmas fabrics. It is in an array of other fabrics. But this is that scrappy dash, double dash. We call it Dashing Through the Snow for the Christmas version. So it's a large churn dash with a little baby churn dash in the middle. And you will love how quickly this goes together. It uses a really cool technique. And when you make the mama churn dash, you also at the same time are making the baby. And so we put it together in this Christmas fabric, this Kimberbell Christmas fabric. It's so stinking adorable. The finished size is 56 inches by 72 inches. It is 30% off today and tomorrow only. So festive 30. And then the other one that I wanted to show you is this one. This is Winter Wonderland. Now we pieced this together during our sit and sew time in November. And I showed you how easy this goes together and it looks, it's just all interwoven. And so this one will finish at 52 by 52. And again, it is 30% off. It has all of the fabrics in there. They're Moda fabrics, beautiful fabrics. And this is all ready for you to make your next Christmas quilt. And we also have, I wanted to show you this one, is my favorite. I had to pull up my favorite yardage that is Christmas yardage that we have right now. I love this. Isn't this so fun? I really love that sage green color. All of our Christmas yardage, 30% off. And it's all there on the Quilt of Joy website. So stitch up a little fun. I will also say we're going to talk about this bundle here in a minute, but all of our 3-yard quilt bundles that are Christmas themed are also 30% off. So pick up some of our Christmas yardage. And when you make your quilt, send me a picture of it because I would love to see it. I'm inherently nosy. I want to know what you're working on. It's super fun to see what everybody's working on. Now we will have a sit and sew that's going to come up in December. It's on December the 20th. And we will be chatting. I'll show you how to quilt a block, how to piece a block. And I hope you enjoyed, in November, I showed you how to piece a stinking cute pumpkin block with a free pattern that we had for you. So if you want to go see that block, if you want to go grab that pattern, head over to our YouTube channel where you can see all of the past sit and sews. We have them recorded. We have all of the past Quilt of Joy clubhouses there recorded as well. So you can go through and watch that. But if you're looking for that pumpkin block for the free pattern as well, you can find that on the sit and sew recording that we did about 2 weeks ago at the end of November. So I showed you this 3-yard quilt bundle. So we've been talking about different 3-yard quilts throughout the year, and they are all based on the 3-yard quilt book. So this is the 3-yard quilt book that is Make It Christmas, and it has all kinds of patterns in here. And one of the cool things about the 3-yard quilt books is it shows you the pattern for this size. This is a 40.5 by 55.5 inch pattern, but it also includes all of the information about how to make it bigger into a twin size, a queen king, and it includes 8 different patterns, 8 different quilts with those 3 sizes for each of these 8 patterns. It's a great, great resource. And so we have a variety of these 3-yard bundles that we have hand selected that we know are going to work great in the 3-yard quilt books for your Christmas quilt, and they are 30% off. So I want to show you this one. This one is, these are Moda fabrics, and this is our Magic of Christmas 3-yard bundle. So it has this cute little buffalo check, the poinsettias with the holly leaves, and then the little mini holly leaves with the green background. And I've pulled it in here into Electric Quilt so that you can see what it looks like. So this is the Bobbles quilt from the 3-yard quilt book, the Make It Christmas 3-yard quilt book. And this is the Bobbles one. And so this is what it would look like with this bundle that I just showed you. Here's another one. Isn't that so cute? That one is also from the Make It Christmas 3-yard bundle book. You can make this with 3 1-yard cuts. This is the lap size. If you want to make a twin, you would get 2 of those bundles, 2 3-yard bundles. And if you wanted to do a queen king, you would need 4 of the 3-yard bundles. So essentially that's 4-yard cuts of 3 different fabrics. So this one, so cute. Here's another one with these same fabrics where they look kind of like a slanted star. Here's one with the kind of the peppermint swirl going on. And here's one with just the star blocks. And then anytime I see a fabric that I really love the focal print of, there are some you just kind of hate to cut into. So don't you love this pattern where it really does showcase a beautiful focal print, and then the star points kind of accentuate that same fabric to the side. And then this is another one that accentuates that that focal print as well. So all of those that I just showed you came from this 3-yard bundle, the Make It Christmas 3-yard bundle. And we have a bunch of other Christmas bundles in there. I think we even have some flannel ones in there. So take a look at our 3-yard bundles that we have. We kind of hand curate them so that we know they're gonna work well in one of the 3-yard quilt books. And if you make it, I would love to see it. Now, that Bobbles quilt that we talked about before. So let me see if I can go backwards here to show you which one I'm talking about when I say Bobbles. So I just want you to know, all right, here's Bobbles. So it looks like ornaments hanging. So I wanna talk to you about how to quilt this. If I were to quilt this, how would I quilt that ornament block, that bobble block? So I've got this over on the long arm. We recorded this earlier. So let's take a look at how you can quilt the Bobbles block from the Make It Christmas 3-yard quilt book. Here's that ornament block laid out from the book. And so it's basically, it's a snowball with a stem, right? But it's an ornament. So of course, for Christmas, the first thing I wanna do is put some, I wanna put some like twisted ribbons on it. So I'm gonna bring up my bobbin thread and I am stitching in white. The yellow really is here just to show you like where the piecing actually is. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I wanna put a loop in here, and that's one side of my ribbon. So I'm gonna do one loop. And now I'm ready to do the second loop. And the second loop, I'm gonna kind of echo out the outside of it, and then I'm gonna cross over at the top. And that will give me that twisted ribbon, that folded ribbon look. All right, I think if it's a ribbon, it needs a little bit of curls. So I'm gonna kick out and do some curls. So a little curl there, tuck it in, and head on back. Okay, so there is one ribbon on this side. Let's do it on the other side. So I'm gonna cross over, I'm gonna do a big loop, an echo, cross, return, and a curl, tuck it in. Okay, so now I have put ribbons on my ornament. And then as far as how to fill the ornament, I'm just gonna do some wishbones. So these are like elongated like infinity signs or figure eights. So I'm gonna just go and do my figure eights and fill out. You could do curls in here too. In fact, on the original pattern, I'm gonna take some tacking stitches here. There are some ornaments that are green and there are some ornaments that are red. So you might do some this way and then some others with just curls in the belly of the ornament. All right, let's take a look. Pretty simple, right? Simple quilting, but it gives that Christmas shine. I might choose a thread that really sings Christmas, like a variegated or something that would really shine, but that would be how to quilt an ornament. I hope that you make a Bobbles quilt, and I would love to see how you quilt it. So head over to our Quilt Joy Clubhouse on Facebook. It's a Facebook group full of the nicest, kindest, most supportive quilters out there. And I would love to see what you're working on. I want to thank our sponsor, APQS. APQS machines are 100% handcrafted in Iowa. They are loved the world over, and they come with a lifetime warranty. If you are interested in an APQS longer machine, call us here at Quilted Joy. You can also send us an email through the website. We have some great specials. We ship coast to coast and Canada too. I would love to talk to you about your long arm journey and see which APQS machine suits that journey the best. You can also contact your local dealer for APQS, your local APQS store, or go to apqs.com for more information. Now I have a looky-loo to show you today. Virgie showed me around her incredible home and her sewing room, and there's some pretty cool stuff that she's got. So let's take a look at Virgie's sewing space. Hi, Virgie. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing good. I'm so glad that you were able to join us today. Thank you.
Sure, you're welcome.
Where are you right now? What state are you in, Virgie?
I'm in Florida.
Nice. Well,
I'm in
and you.
Northwest Florida.
Northwest Florida. Okay. And you came by our shop here in Louisville and said hello to me on your journeys through Kentucky. And I appreciate that. It was nice meeting you.
That was so fun.
Well, good. Well, I can't wait to see your space. So turn your camera around so we can see your sewing space.
Yeah.
Your fabric is beautiful.
Oh, well, thank you. Let me back up a little bit so that you can see more of the bookshelf that's there. Because I like storing my fabric on the comic board strip pieces. And I try to group it according to color. And I just love fabric. I really do. And part of the fun is arranging it.
Yeah.
I love to come and play with it and rearrange it.
Yeah. Yeah, that's gorgeous. So you're in your house?
I've got this bookcase that my husband built. Yes. Yes.
Okay.
We're
oh,
in
my
the room
goodness.
That actually is across from the dining room. And one of the things I love about this room is if I need to, I can just shut the door.
That so tell me what I'm seeing there, because that almost looks like it came from an apothecary or something like that.
It did. My husband found this cabinet. Somebody had it in the garage in Tallahassee, and he found it, I think, on Marketplace.
Wow.
And showed it to me, and he says, "Virgie, can you use this?" I said, "Are you kidding?" Yes.
Yeah.
So he made arrangements to go over and get it and pick it up. And it took several of his friends to help move it into the house. But I have a lot of storage in this. I have the downstairs doors and drawers.
Uh-huh.
And we won't open the doors and drawers today. But I do like arranging the fabric and playing with it.
Yeah.
And I love buying fabrics on sale.
Uh-huh.
Because I actually have the room to store it.
Very nice.
So this is where I keep some of my favorite things, my favorite fabrics.
Yeah, I see a magazine I recognize.
Yeah. that's got some projects in there I really want to do. So
Okay.
But once I pick a project, then I come start shopping for fabric.
Mm.
And I can shop in my own sewing room here.
Cute.
And there's another cabinet here
that
my husband found at a different time.
It's a card catalog.
And this was actually part of an apothecary cabinet.
Oh.
And all of these labels, you can see, let me see if I can show you at the bottom. Some of them actually have the old labels still there.
Wow.
Because we thought it was just pretty cool to save that.
Really cool.
Then my daughter got me organized and made labels for these top drawers.
So what do you keep in there? Can you open one of them? Can we see in one of them?
Yeah. This is a drawer that has extra scissors.
Nice.
So I can do that.
Wow.
I have one that's labeled rulers, although this is not all the rulers I have. So I do have some rulers in here. Part of it is Christmas stuff and labels, patterns.
Uh-huh. Very cool.
So, yeah.
Nice. So you do all your piecing in that room?
No. Since I have a long arm room upstairs, I keep all my fabrics here.
Oh.
And then I move the fabrics to the cutting station upstairs.
Okay. So in this
room. That way I can do that while my long arm is running.
Got it.
And I can be in the same room to hear my long arm run.
Okay, so that center table that you have there, that's when you pick out fabric and you can lay it out and audition.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Oh, oh my goodness. Wait, Virgie, what is holding up the center table? Those are treadle machines.
These are old sewing machine bases.
Love it.
And we had them stored in the barn. We really didn't know what we were going to do with them. And when we moved in to this house, I needed a table. So I asked Tom, would he make me a table with these bases, which he did. And it's a door.
Wow.
We found an old door. And then we had the glass cut fit on top of the door to make a table out of it.
I love that. That is so awesome. Well, he gets a gold star because that's phenomenal.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he does.
So you have your own little personal fabric shop on the first floor, and then you've got your sewing studio on the second floor.
I do.
All right. Well, I want to see the second floor, Virgie. So I'm going to have you climb the stairs.
Okay. All right. Okay. Here goes the fun.
Okay.
I do a lot of up and down multiple times a day, which is okay because it's just good exercise. But this staircase actually came from New York City.
Oh my goodness.
From an old house. And when
from a what?
Tom bought it, then we had it shipped. Wow. Okay, so here's the long arm room. Now that I'm at the top of the stairs.
Oh, that's lovely. Okay, so you have it's like a landing. It's not a room. It's like a landing zone at the top of the stairs. And then
a lot of people would call this room a bonus room.
Okay.
In upstairs. And there's a bedroom on either side of the bonus room and a bathroom.
Okay. And so you've got, is that a 10-foot table, a 12-foot table?
It's 12-foot.
A 12-foot. And you've got an APQS machine. I can't see, which model do you have of the APQS machine? Is it a Millie?
It's a Freddy.
A Freddy. Nice.
Freedom.
A Freedom. Uh-huh. And you've got the IntelliQuilter on it. And
I do.
And you've got some quilts hanging there behind.
And I dearly love it.
Yeah, good. You've got some quilts there hanging behind it. I see.
I do.
So while the computer is driving the machine, then you can be piecing and working in the same room.
Exactly. Right. Yeah.
Nice.
Here's why I have my sewing machine set up.
Uh-huh. Lovely.
So.
And then is that a kitchen table that you just put up on little risers for your cutting table?
It is. Mm-hmm. It is. That way it makes the height comfortable.
Uh-huh.
Or I can do cutting.
Uh-huh.
And I have storage underneath.
Great.
Not sure. It seems like my camera's moving a little bit slow, but.
Yeah. Yeah. I think
it may look a little jerky.
It's still catching up from that jog up the stairs. So you can iron there. I see. And then, and then cut on that table. And then you've got all your thread kind of displayed over on the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I just, and then you've got a bathroom up there, and when you get tired, you can just go lay down.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the bedroom that's next to my long arm room.
Mm-hmm.
And I have gradually encroached into the room next door. This is where I hang quilts while they're waiting to be quilted.
Nice.
And I do have some storage in here.
Uh-huh.
That's where I store most of my batting.
Okay.
And another antique cabinet.
Yeah.
That stores more batting.
Oh, all right.
More fabric.
All right. Nice.
This is where I mostly keep my wide backs.
Sure.
And batting.
That makes sense because it's right there by the machine. And I love that you could actually have a quilt on that bed too and get a lovely photo of the finished quilt. Beautiful. Just beautiful.
That was a fun project.
Yeah. Well, Virgie, can you turn that camera around so we can see your smiling face?
There we go.
Virgie, thank you so much for showing me your space. It's beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
I love how you've taken the antiques and kind of woven them into all of your sewing space. Yeah. It's really beautiful. Well, Virgie, tell me three things that you're currently into that you would recommend to your bestie. They don't have to be quilt related, but what are three things that you're currently finding kind of cool?
Well, my ideas are quilt related. And my three things would be, number one, always continue to learn something new. Number two would be find somebody to share that information with. And number three would be to be easy on yourself and not too judgmental, especially when you're first starting out to do anything, whether it's learning to quilt or learning to long arm, whatever it is. Just give yourself space and time to learn.
I totally agree, Virgie. Yep.
Yeah.
It's kind of like learning to walk. You're going to fall down and bump your toe and your nose occasionally. And that's just part of the process. You get up, you dust yourself off and you keep on going.
Yes. Yeah. And find somebody to enjoy it with.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. The quilting community that you can find in every city across the country is so supportive, and they just can't wait to welcome you with open arms. So I agree. You're find
so
that
fun.
Community. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for spending some time with me, Virgie. If someone wants to connect with you, where can they find you online?
I have a Facebook page for my long arm business, which is Holmes Creek Quilting. And that's how you can find me. I'm in Northwest Florida between Tallahassee and Pensacola.
Fabulous. Thank you so much for your time, Virgie. I'll see you in the clubhouse.
Well, thank you.
Okay. See ya.
Bye.
Thanks so much, Virgie. I loved your space. I love your staircase. That's pretty amazing. We have some new arrivals that have arrived in the shop, and one of them is pretty interesting. I've never seen, this is a new concept to the quilting world, and I find it fascinating. So it is binding on the bolt. Okay, so let me show you what I'm talking about. So it's from Art Gallery Fabrics, and it is binding. So these are 2.5-inch strips. And you can see the little, can you see them, Rachel, the little scissors right there? So when you cut this from selvage to selvage, you cut on that little scissor line. It's this little yellow line here. And when you cut it into strips, you're gonna pull it off the bolt, and it is, oh, it fell on the floor. I was like, where the heck did it go? Okay, so when I cut it off the bolt, so this is what I'm gonna cut off the bolt. Can you see that okay?
It's upside down.
It's upside down, oh, okay. Oh, sorry, and I hit the camera. Okay, so when you cut it off the bolt, that's what it's going to look like. Okay, so now I would take it to the ironing board and I would fold it over and press it. And that's going to get me, here, I'm going to put this on the backside, Rachel. Maybe this will help so that they can see it a little bit better. Is that helpful? So now when I fold it, and it's ready to attach to my quilt. So one side of this binding will have little adorable cars, and the other side of the binding has the little UFO spaceships. Wouldn't that be so fun on a kiddo quilt? So fun. So it's binding, it's printed binding, and it's printed on the bolt from selvage to selvage, and we have a variety of them. So this is that one that I just showed you with the cars and the spaceships, and you'd cut it, the strips, fold it in half. It's ready to go as binding. And then this one, I gotta flip it over. Okay, this one, it says, handmade with love, one of a kind. And do you see the little scissors? So that is where you would cut. You'd cut right on that little dash line, and that gives you a 2.5-inch strip of binding. You just fold it in half. One half of your binding will say handmade, one of a kind, and the other half will say handmade with love on this side. And then we also have a variety of these that are made in really striking patterns. So again, let's think about that this little dashed line is our cut line, so that we're going to cut these strips 2.5-inch and then fold them in half. So you can see the front of your binding, well, I guess it depends on how you attach it to your quilt, but one side of your quilt would have these larger stripes and the other side would have these smaller stripes on the binding. So it's a printed binding where the front of the binding is different than the back of the binding. And we have a whole variety of these in the shop that arrived, and they are really cool. I mean, I've not seen this before. And this is by Art Gallery Fabrics. Really interesting, fun binding. And then we also got in, these are our batik backing fabrics. So these, oh, I just ripped that. I'm gonna have to tape that, Rachel. I was pulling off so they could see it. So these are pre-cut 3-yard bundles of wide back batiks, wide back batiks, and they are in lots of luscious, gorgeous colors. This one has kind of a fall colorway to it. It's got those purples and oranges and greens. It's just gorgeous. So we have a variety of these. These are Banyan batiks by Northcott, and they are 3 yards, so 108 by 108. And those are all over there in the Quilted Joy shop. We have, goodness gracious, I think we just brought in 200 pounds of fabric yesterday. So we have so much new stuff on our website. As you probably know, we just moved into a new facility. And so we have all this room. So we're kind of stretching our legs and feeling out the space and filling it up. And anything that we have in the store, we also have online, because we know we have so many of you who don't have an opportunity to come to Louisville, Kentucky and shop in our store. So we have everything online for you. If you are coming through or to Louisville, I would love to meet you, love to see you. So stop by the shop. We are off of I-65, I-71, and I-64. They all kind of converge here. So if you're going down any of those highways, you are not far from us. So stop by in Louisville, Kentucky at Quilted Joy, and I would love to see you. All right, I do have some show and tells for you. And so these are quilts that have been posted over on our Facebook group, our Quilted Joy Facebook group. And let's do a little quilt drooling here and see what people have been up to. So this one is one that Christine posted. And have you seen these? They're panels for the different national parks. And so this one is for Yellowstone. This is on my bucket list. I need to get to Yellowstone. And so it has the buffalo. Now really look closely at what Christine did with her machine quilting. Look at how she added the buffalo, the fur on the buffalo. Look at how she added the waves to the plains that the buffalo is standing on. Look at the mountains. Look at how she kind of carved the face of the mountains out. So if you look at panels, now Christine says that she's generally not a fan of panels, but this was so much fun. So if you start to look at panels more as playgrounds, as sandboxes of places to play with low entry. So, you know, a panel like this doesn't cost very much. And then look, she's just got some flying geese there on the edge. There's not a lot of piecing involved, but it can help stretch and grow your machine quilting skills. Thanks for sending that in, Christine. Angela, you posted this one. She said that this is her most recent quilt. She used a wandering pine cone stitch pattern for the quilting, and that it was made for a lifelong friend that loves the outdoors and nature, and all that's left to do is bind it and deliver it. Now, Angela says this was the third quilt she did on her long arm machine. She says that she's still building her skill set and that she really hopes that her friend likes it. Great job, Angela. Thank you so much. I can't believe that's your third quilt. So good. And then Angela also sent this one in. She says, I just finished the quilting for this bundle of sunshine. I selected this one for a woman that was so totally there for me when my life was turned completely upside down, and I wanted something that was radiant and joyful every time she looks at it. It is quilted with a happy little pattern called Bumblebee Garden. It's a series of bumblebees and vines, and this is made with nothing but love. I love that, Angela. Thank you so much for sending that in. Lori, this is so cute. You probably know, Lori, that I am a big cat lover. If it were up to me, that's the only kind of fabric I would ever buy is cat fabric. But Lori, this is her latest quilt. Isn't that cute with the pumpkins and all the little black kitties? I like, Lori, how you used different black fabrics. You know, each of these little kitties has a little personality to them. I like that a lot. Nancy, this is so beautiful. Nancy says that a friend was cleaning out the sewing room of a fellow quilter that passed on, and she fell in love with this quilt top that was never quilted. So she asked me to quilt it on my Millie, and this is what I did for her. She was so pleased with it, and I am obsessed with rulers. Well, Nancy, I am obsessed with rulers too, and I am so impressed. I love how you made this chandelier quilt sing. Just beautiful. Thanks for sending that in. And do pay attention to how Nancy did these, the four patches all along the outside with those orange peel kind of shapes going through. Nice job, Nancy. Tammy posted this one. She said, here's the latest long arm quilting job off my machine. It was delivered to my client Linda, who pieced it using the Winter Manor quilt pattern. And Tammy says that as a freehand quilter, she gets inspiration from a variety of places. And this time she created her version of a Holly Berry scroll by Urban Elements. And Tammy. It is so beautiful. I'm not sure if this is a panel. Surely that's a panel. Surely your client didn't. Those aren't like hand applique. I bet that's a panel that she cut. It's a really interesting setting too for the panel. I love it. Nice job, Tammy. Barbara says that she was a little puzzled about how to quilt the cardinal square. So don't we all have this where you have a large piece of fabric, it's a focal print, you're not quite sure what to do with it. She said she didn't want to overpower the picture, so she opted to make it look like you were seeing those little cardinals through a window pane. And then she did leaves and ribbon candy free motion in those white negative spaces, and she's got some ribbon candy in those red frames. Beautiful job, Barbara. And Barbara also posted this one. So she says that she finished this top for a customer this week. She's really happy with the way it turned out. She did ruler work in a free motion filler with glide thread. You did a beautiful block. I bet your customer loved it. Thank you so much for sending those in, you guys. That one we had from last month. Sorry, yes. Thank you so much for sending those in, you guys. It's always fun to see what you are working on. So make sure that you're in our Facebook group, the Quilts Joy Facebook group. And over there in the Facebook group, post what you're working on so that we can celebrate with you. And other people like to post a quilt top that is unquilted and ask for suggestions on how to quilt it. So you will find so many wonderful, helpful folks inside our Facebook group. And I really do hope that you join us over there. If you have enjoyed our Quilted Joy Clubhouse, I would ask that you head over and review us on Google. It really helps that giant Google monster machine decide to serve us up to other folks. It's kind of hard to break through the Google monster machine, all the algorithms, but your reviews really do help do that. So if you have found this helpful, I do read everyone and I appreciate your time for doing it. And of course, if you have a friend that you think would enjoy the Quilted Joy Clubhouse, please share the Quilted Joy Clubhouse with them as well. So I am looking forward to seeing you at our Sit and Sew on December the 20th. It will be at 1 o'clock Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific, right here on the Quilted Joy website, Quilted Joy Facebook group, Quilted Joy Facebook Clubhouse group, and on YouTube. We're all over the place. And so join me. We really kind of chat and just kind of shoot the breeze and have a little fun and do and piece a block together. So that'll be December the 20th. And then on Wednesday, January 3rd is the next time that we'll meet here for our Quilted Joy Clubhouse. That's at 1 o'clock Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific. Of course, you can always find us on Facebook, our Facebook page, our Facebook group, and on Instagram. And of course, all the previous recordings of the Clubhouse are over on YouTube. If you are close to Louisville, we also have all of our classes have now rolled out for the first quarter of 2024. So you can find all of those on our website with color photos. So you can see all of the classes that you could attend here in person. We would love to see you. Many of them I teach, some others teach, but I would just love to see if you can stop by. All right, you guys, I appreciate your time and I hope to see you in the Clubhouse in the future. All right, bye.